our partners in health and friends, senior officials of the Ministry of Health. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for this invitation, and thank you for being here on this important virtual and face-to-face event for the Ministry, in particular for the services we provide for people living with HIV/AIDS in Fiji. Today's event marks the coming together of effort and dedication, commitment and passion of many partners, organizations and individuals to overcome the many challenges we currently face in delivering health services to our people, and among which is the COVID-19 pandemic which we are facing at the moment. The pandemic, which is into its 19th month globally, has challenged the ability of health services to around the world to deliver their normal functions. And in Fiji, this includes our program to care for those with chronic diseases such as HIV/AIDS has not been spared. But as we continue and as the days go on, we'll learn more and more how to adapt our practice and services better to the new normal of doing things, and we are slowly and surely improving and escalating our response while retaining programs that are impacted, that were impacted to its full capacity. For HIV/AIDS, since 1989, we've had significant developments, both locally and internationally. 30 years later, we can say that HIV is no longer a death sentence, and people can live normal lives after being diagnosed with HIV. While HIV does not have a vaccine yet to prevent it, we have life-saving treatment available, and the Fijian government has remained committed to providing free medications to people living with HIV for more than a decade now. In 2020, we had 147 cases, and 84 were in the Central Eastern Division, 49 in the West, and 14 in the Northern Division. We had 13 children, and 90% of them, as usual, got infected during pregnancy, which HIV was transmitted from mother to child. And as of December 2020, a cumulative 1,266 people have been diagnosed with HIV since 1989. This keeps the prevalence of 0.14%, and 73% of them, or the majority of them, were between 20 to 39 years, with 3% were adolescent. For the past 3 years, there have been an increase in the number of MSM and transgender cases who have been diagnosed with HIV, thus warranting strategies on the need to scale up testing in priority populations. Of the cumulative cases in Fiji, 78% of these individuals are on this life-changing HIV treatment. While we have the Fiji HIV Act, there's been a need to review and upgrade the necessary policies and strategies and guidelines, bearing in mind the scientific updates that have readily become available. Recently, Fiji has reviewed and updated the following critical guiding documents which are in line with WHO recommendations. They are the Prevention of Parent-to-Child Transmission of HIV and Syphilis Policy, the HIV Care and ART Management Guidelines, or Antiretroviral Treatment Guidelines, and the Comprehensive Management of STIs Guidelines. The Ministry of Health and Medical Services have been working with our UN partners to secure processes in place for the procurement of HIV medicines and testing capacity, and to ensure that it's sustained. And during this pandemic, while we are battling with the pandemic, we ensure that we sustain the normative functions for people with chronic diseases, including the care for people living with HIV/AIDS, by establishing telemedicine for consultation and delivery of medicine to patients, keeping clinics open for patients who require face-to-face services, and most importantly, providing vaccination for positive patients at the vaccination sites. Several people with HIV, also diagnosed with COVID-19, were supported and have fully recovered. The advancement of treatment and undetectable viral load has brought success and better life quality to individuals living with HIV today. Fiji recorded one death of a HIV patient who was diagnosed with COVID-19, and this death was not due to the disease but died with the disease. We are currently in the process of relooking our strategic guidance and policies to further strengthen our HIV program through collaboration for community testing by partnering with government and non-governmental organizations across Fiji. We want to strengthen the capacity of our health workers to diagnose and treat healthcare workers, and review and adopt Fiji's HIV testing and counseling strategies and policies. We want to upscale Fiji's preventative programs, such as the condom program and known one status of HIV, and reviewing and ensuring we come to zero transmission of HIV from mother to children, which Fiji has achieved at one point in time. We also continue to strengthen the role and functions of the HIV board in supporting people living with HIV, of which 78% of these individuals, as I've alluded to earlier, are on the life-changing HIV medicines. During the second wave of COVID-19 in Fiji, with the reduced flights and availability of HIV treatment, UNAIDS assisted and led the coordination between UNAIDS, DFAT, and Ministry of Health and Medical Services for this much-needed HIV medicines to the ministry. UNAIDS was able to secure a donation of $570,000 worth of first-line antiretroviral drugs from Atlanta Medicare. They've also, UNAIDS, contributed $77,000 for airfare costs to this donation. DFAT, for the donation of pediatric HIV drugs and freight purchased from Thailand, amounting to just over $10,000. And also, we sincerely are appreciative of the support by our partners, DFAT, Atlanta Medicare, and UNAIDS. Fijian government remains committed to supporting the HIV program for all Fijians. And today we've come and also would like to really thank His Excellency, the Speaker of the House of Representatives of Fiji, for his enormous role as a champion for HIV AIDS, not only in Fiji or in the Pacific, for all around the world, for being with us today. Nabulu, sir, and thank you.